question for you. What one food combines ancient Egypt, Mesoamerica, and a Connecticut minister who didn't want anybody to get excited about much of anything?
I have no idea.
S'mores.
No way.
Yes, yes. So that sandwich, graham crackers and marshmallows and chocolate all together, that sandwich combines so much history. Let's talk about marshmallows first. Marshmallows, naturally, are a flowering plant growing along the Nile River. And it was used very often when there was no other food around in times of famine. What we have right here is actually not a marshmallow in the sense of the flowers. So the French added sugar and turned it into a dessert. So it is gelatin, sugar, and air. Pretty much like we have here.
No way. What about chocolate?
Chocolate was considered to be the food of the gods in pre-Hispanic Mesoamerica. Chocolate was originally considered to be both magical and medicinal, and was consumed as a beverage or a sauce. Fast forward to the late 1800s when Cadbury and Nestle turned chocolate into a bar and added milk powder to make the chocolate less bitter. These bars are actually crystallized solid fat suspending cocoa particles and sugar. Milton Hershey then applied assembly line techniques to make chocolate affordable to the masses. The magic and medicine had now become candy. Graham crackers are credited to Sylvester Graham. He was a Presbyterian minister in the mid-1800s who was part of the temperance movement. This movement was not just about not drinking alcohol, but also about controlling desire, including sexual desire, through diet. Harvey Kellogg, who invented cornflakes, had similar ideas about controlling fleshly desires with bland diets. Reverend Graham created a very coarse ground flour, which became known as Graham flour. And this was later used to make graham crackers. So essentially, I guess we could say that s'mores are an abstinence, decadence, abstinence sandwich.
Or a delicious bonfire treat.
Better idea. Well, let's go talk about the science.
All right.
So these graham crackers are designed to shatter, just like other crispy foods. They're an edible form of glass.
That's so cool.
Did you notice all the little holes in here?
Yeah, why are they there?
It's designed to keep the cracker flat when it heats in the oven. So how about we roast some marshmallows? What do you think?
Yeah, but no bonfire. So let's use this.
All right, let's try it out. Let me hold this and I'll narrate as you're roasting. So if we're careful about this, the reaction between sugars and proteins will cause Maillard browning. We should see some nice browning occur. I think it's starting to happen. Now, if we're not careful about this, what's going to happen is we're going to light these on fire. And that's because sugar is a great fuel. How do you like your marshmallows?
Usually not this done.
Okay, let's put them out and see if we can make a s'more. What do you think?
Yeah.
All right. All right, grab the chocolate, and I'll put the marshmallow. There you go, and you got it. S'more number one. And let's make another one. And s'more number two. Delicious.
Beautiful. Cheers.
Cheers.